hitting a little too close to home after everything with Murph.
I'm good. I just need a quick shower and I'll be good to go.
Not in there. The bathroom's down the hall.
Okay.
That's Mackie's old room.
I rest, you clowns. Why do I have to be the one in the bag?
Because you suck at rock, paper, scissors.
There is no logical world where paper beats rock.
Look at the edges of the wounds. They're cauterized. Whatever singed the hospital room got him too.
The cuts are too clean to be claws or teeth, so that rules out manicore. These came from a blade, which must be why they're assuming it's a suicide.
Well, these cuts are deep, so whatever did it was strong.
A burning blade sounds more like a component of a sacrifice.
Did you reach out? Stay with me. Please.
I don't. Carlos, get back in the bag. Lock the door.
Seriously, again?
Carlos, let's do it.
Watch the hair. Okay, just shush. Go. Excuse me. I'm here to pick up my husband's effects.
Mrs. Pasternak, I'm Joan Mitchell, forensic autopsy technician, and this is my associate, Graham Nash. We are so sorry for your loss.
Is that Patches Cross?
It's passionate. On behalf of everyone here at Pendle Park, I'd like to thank you for asking service. Excuse me, I'm not asking.
Are you okay?
Bad breakfast. Feeling better now.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm fine. So what's going on?
Okay, well, while you were busy, we came up with a plan. Lata and I are going to check out a reporter Mrs. Pasternak talked to. But we still need to get inside the psych unit. Get eyes on Patch's doctor and his fellow patients, so... I hope you and Carlos are ready to tell your best war stories. Because you're enrolling in Patch's therapy group.
Who's next? An eager newcomer. I don't think we've met yet. Won't you tell us about yourself?
Carlos Cervantes, Navy medic. My whole life was in a band. My clothes, my records, my guitar. I lived life off the grid. Free as a bird. But then I got arrested, and the judge said it was either jail or service, and I wasn't about to give up freedom on the open road for a cell, so next thing I know, I'm in the Mekong Delta, taking second watch, surveilling the coast with the worst haircut of my life. I remember there were these dots in the jungle. Didn't know what they were, but they were beautiful. Like blinking Christmas lights. But then I realized they were the cherries from the Viet Cong cigarettes. I was watching them, and they were watching us. I still see those dots sometimes. I guess it doesn't matter how I got there or how I felt about the war. Circumstances might be different. But our trauma is the same.
you for sharing, Carlos.
Well, thank you for giving me the space to share, Dr. Z. I think I'm gonna go freshen up. My friend here would actually love to go next, right, John?
Carlos, Carlos. Nice to meet you, John. Tell us about yourself.
No, thanks, guys. I'm good just listening.
Someone tells me you didn't come all this way just to listen. What's your story?
I was a Marine in Vietnam. My company was involved in an operation in the mountains south of Penang. Things were bad. We were ambushed. My buddy stepped on a landmine. I saw it happen.
I'm so sorry for your loss, John.
Yeah. My friend died. And all I got was a lousy scar.
Losing a friend like that must have been unbearable. If you can, tell us what's coming up for you.
Give him a break, Doc. You're raised, bottled up. Be a man.
Look where that got us, sitting in a hospital.
Wasting time. I've about had it with this damn group. You don't listen to us. You for damn sure didn't listen to Patches.
All right, that's quite enough. Everybody, let's take 10. Jimmy, my office.
Yeah, like hell.
Jimmy, wait up. Hey, Jimmy, wait up. What happened between Dr. Z and Patches?
What did you find in Dr. Z's office?
According to his notes, Patches was haunted by images of a man with a horned mask holding a spear. That description ring any bells?
It sounds like a pretty classical mythological figure, but that doesn't exactly narrow it down.
Dr. Z was with the group when it happened, okay? So whatever this is, he isn't in it. But he knew about it.
You think he was covering it up?
No, but I'm gonna find out.
Hey, just
keep an eye on him. And hang tight until we figure out what this monster is, okay?
Got it.
John? John, this isn't the answer.
Who's the man in the horned mask?
What?
The one that Patches saw before he died. The one I saw.
Son, I'm sorry. I know how hard today has been. First Patches, now Jimmy. I am feeling it too. But there is no man in the horned mask.
Come on, John, take it easy.
What you are seeing, it isn't real. There are no monsters in this hospital.
You saw the man in the mask? Back at the morgue. I saw Patches' cross necklace. It took me back.
Did you talk about it in the group?
In the group? Dr. Z, you tell me you're not buying into all this crap.
When I got back from Nam, I thought the less I said, the better. But today, sharing what I went through, I completely forgot about this case and why we're here. Talking about it actually helped. Listen, well, we're out of suspects, but at least we know what we're looking for, so while Mary and Lotta hit the books, let's you and I split up, search for more of these burn marks, and see if they lead us on the trail where the man in the mask is hiding.
Mars Nettown. A Celtiberian deity based on the Roman god Mars. Do you think this is him?
It's a fiery spear of horned mask, just like Patches described. Forget monster. We've never faced anything like this. And John and Carlos have no idea.
That they're up against a god.
A god? Why are you alone? Get out of there.
Carlos.
Every time I think I find the exit, I get turned back around again. It's like a maze had a baby with a jungle. So this place is real. To you and me? Yeah. Hell, is the sweat soaking my new velvet shirt. I've tried any way I can to escape, but I don't think we can just walk away. I think we have to face what's in here if we want to get out.
You mean who's in here? The monster with the horn mask? The one that killed Patches and Jimmy? If he wants a fight, he'll get one.
No, John, hold on.
John? Don't move.
It does. Things will be okay, I promise. Just don't move. I wasn't planning on it.
Men of action are so glad to come alive. Welcome, Corporal Winchester.
How do you know who I am? I saw you die.
Gods can't die. Although we can bleed and be made to look well. Awfully messy.
So you're telling me all of that was Peter?
Everything I did for you was to get you to embrace your anger, to get you ready.
Ready for what?
The Akrida. I know the Akrida are already here. You and your hunter friends are too weak to stop them. But you, a hunter and a soldier, you could be sharpened into a powerful weapon.
If I agree to help you, you let my friend go.
John, please, there's gotta be another
Carlos,
way.
Just fight me and draw first blood. You join me, and your friend goes free. And if you don't, it's the spear. Both of you.
Please.
Alright. Let's do this.
Your past is holding you back. Let me wipe the slate clean. Soldier.
Did he heal?
This one belongs to you. Claim it.
Ironic, isn't it? That a god's immortality would be tied to something that appears so fragile.
We do not have time for irony. Now, how do we know if it worked?
I don't know what you did, but it worked. The mine's gone.
I can take you two home.
It'd be great.
Hey, Winchester, before you go, I just want to thank you for what you did back there.
You're welcome.
If you ever want to talk, you let me know, okay? The monster we're hunting is sort of like a brain vampire.
You mentioned he'd been suffering from nightmares.
Doesn't matter how the monsters get to us. It's our job to hunt them. If you do not go through that door right now,
you're running out of time.
We'll die.